Good day. The other day I came across someone asking the question, how much does a simulator actually help in learning FPV? Another question we always hear, and have asked at some point ourselves, is what's the best way to get started with FPV? Today I'm going to give you my answers to both of these questions by briefly going over a couple of the things I teach in more detail in the Fast Track FPV course. Specifically, the best and most inexpensive way to get started with FPV is by purchasing a good value, future-proof transmitter and a simulator with good flight physics. I go over the rationale for my recommendations on a good value transmitter in this video, Best Beginner FPV Drone Kit, which you can access through the TMacFPV.com free resources page or through the link in the video description below. I'll also go over the benefits of using an FPV simulator, take a brief look at what I consider to be the top three FPV simulators, Velocidrone, DRL, and Liftoff, to include cost, system requirements, and available support groups. This is not an in-depth review of any FPV simulator. For that, I'll refer you to SFPV's 52-minute review of what he considers to be the top 10 simulators for 2019, as well as his blog post, both of which are available through links in the video description below. Colby's top three in that video are also the three main ones I'll touch on here as well. I'll then actually use one of these top three FPV simulators to build a basic course using its track editor and go through a few practice drills you can use to get started with FPV flight. Sound good? Then give it a thumbs up below, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff.
First, why should we use simulators at all? Well, they are a form of accelerated learning. Through their deliberate use, you'll learn to fly FPV and new maneuvers faster by using them than if you only practiced with real quads. I said deliberate because you do, in fact, need to practice with a purpose. Have an objective for your practice session. What is it that you'll be working on to improve? Flying around aimlessly, although maybe entertaining, will have less of an effect on improving your flight skills. You can fly anytime, day or night, in any type of weather, which is very convenient. They're quick to set up and start flying, which saves you time. You can practice your flight skills until they become second nature, and when you crash, you can just hit the reset button instead of having to go get your quad and relaunch it every time. To use them, you only need a transmitter, which means you can start learning to fly without having purchased goggles first. In fact, most people don't use goggles while flying simulators. And when you use them prior to actual flight, you'll get most of your initial hard crashes out of the way before you throttle up on a real quad. The world's air forces have understood the importance of integrating simulator use into pilot training for quite some time. The use of simulators enables accelerated, low-cost, and learning-focused training. Recent graduates of the U.S. Air Force Pilot Training Next program spent 6 months of learning to fly with simulators before their first flight in an actual aircraft. In fact, they spent more time on the simulators than they did in actual aircraft. Now, I understand you're not learning to fly a fighter aircraft, but the fact that the world's air forces, whose lives depend on their skills, use simulators this extensively should give you confidence knowing they'll be quite useful to you in enhancing your FPV flight skills. Let's take a look at some of the simulators that are out there. In my opinion, the three with the best flight physics, most realistic, i.e. flight simulators as opposed to just games, also with the most robust features currently in use, are Velocidrone, Drone Racing League, or DRL, and Liftoff. All three of these you'll find useful for practice, and all three are similar in cost at this time. When looking for a simulator to simulate real-world flying, the main thing to take into consideration is its flight physics. Out of these three, I find both Velocidrone and DRL to have the best physics, and there's another simulator out there called FPV Air 2, which can also be purchased on Steam for $4.99, that also has good physics, but is currently not as robust in features and tracks as these other three. These are the system requirements for each of the three simulators previously mentioned. I own and have used all three, and the one I use primarily is Velocidrone. Liftoff seems to take a while to load on my machine every time I go back and forth between menus, therefore I don't use that one as much. Your experience with any of these simulators, however, may be different than mine due to your computer's configuration. Mine's not a high-end gaming computer. I happen to be running a Windows-based AMD Athlon X4 860K quad-core 3.7 GHz processor with a GeForce GTX 1050 Ti graphics card. All three of these simulators have different levels of presence on social media platforms with their own followings. They all have Facebook and Instagram accounts and can also be found on Twitch TV. All three also have their own racing league competitions, which can be a lot of fun. To start using the sims, all you have to do is download and install them, then calibrate your transmitter sticks, which on Velocidrone, DRL, and Liftoff is an easy process. Then it's just a matter of entering the specific simulator's training mode, and each has their own unique training section. Velocidrone has 44 different flight training videos, 14 are line of sight, and 30 are FPV, all of which can be accessed under the support section of the Velocidrone.com website, on YouTube, or under the tutorials menu item in the simulator itself. DRL has its own train menu section, which starts out at the beginner level in angle mode, which is a self-leveling mode, which I don't necessarily think is a good thing because sometimes it feels as though you're fighting the quad. And if you're in that mode practicing a lot, you might end up forming bad habits, which you'll then need to overcome later. It stays in this beginner self-leveling mode for the first 34 training sessions. That's a lot of time to learn some bad habits. It is, however, a good, structured training program broken down into three quests at three different skill levels, beginner, intermediate, and pro, encompassing 54 different missions, the last 20 of which can be run in both intermediate, which is what they call angle limited, or what's called an beta flight acro trainer, or also the pro skill level, or what they call manual, which in beta flight is called acro modes. Liftoff has 9 tutorial videos within the game, which are run on a blue grid-like environment. Any of these three simulators will help you learn to fly initially and also learn new maneuvers, and you don't necessarily need to limit yourself to just one. You may actually enjoy some features each one has uniquely to itself. I've listed these simulators in the order of my preference, based on my opinion of their flight physics. However, you and others may have a different opinion. Regardless of your choice of simulator, I highly recommend using at least one of these for increasing your flight skills throughout your journey and while practicing flight drills, such as those few we'll be going over next. The simulator we'll be using is Velocidrone, and before we get started with our few drills, I wanted to demonstrate just how easy it is to build your own track using Velocidrone. We go into Track Editor, create new track, empty scene day, select scenery, and it brings this canvas up. This is our empty scene day. The first thing we need to do is put a starting gate. This is one of the required items for any track. So we'll place our gate there. And for our drills, we're just going to use 5 flags. I'm going to select green ones, and I'm going to put 3 in a row. And then 2 over here. And this is going to be our track for our practice flight drills. We'll be doing 4 practice drills with this particular track that we built. The first one we're going to do is we're going to start off hovering. We're going to start with our quadcopter on our start pad, or our launch pad here, which is normally the case. And what we're going to do is practice hovering the quadcopter in front of this flag, keeping these flags all in a line with each other as much as possible. So when our quadcopter drifts right or left, we'll notice that these flags are no longer in line with this flag from our line of sight. So what we want to focus on is trying to maintain the same height above the ground, below the tops of these flags, and keep these 3 flags in the same line. That's going to be our first drill. Our second drill that we'll do is, once again, we'll start from our launch pad, and we'll try to maintain our height below the tops of these flags, and we'll slowly fly forward with the quadcopter until we reach the first flag, and then we'll use the pitch stick and pitch back to slow our speed down. Then we'll pitch forward and go to the next flag and pitch back to slow down. Then we'll pitch forward to go to the third flag and pitch back to slow down. And our objective in learning this is slow forward flight and how to slow down when you're in slow forward flight. The third practice drill we'll do is once again start from the launch pad, and we'll fly around these 4 flags, practicing our coordinated turns using both yaw and roll. And we'll do that in one direction, and then we'll go ahead and do it in another direction. And it's important to keep in mind that you want to do your practice drills in both directions so that you don't just get one predominant direction that you're used to flying all the time. And our last practice drill we'll do during this particular video is we'll work on more of our coordinated turns doing figure eights around two of these flags. And those will be tighter coordinated turns using both yaw and roll. All right, let's get to it. We go to single player. There's lots of quadcopters that you could pick over here. I'm just gonna use the one that I always use, Mode 2 Ghost. I'm gonna select the quadcopter. Then we select our scene, and there's lots of scenes to choose from. And within each scene, there's lots of tracks to choose from. We're gonna go to our empty scene day and the custom track that we just made for these particular flight drills. And that would be simulator practice drills. So we're gonna select that scenery and it's gonna load. We're currently looking out of our quadcopter's FPV camera, and these are the three flags directly in front of us, and these are the two over on our left-hand side. First thing we wanna do, since we're practicing hovering, is we wanna lower our camera angle. We do that by hitting page down, and you can see our camera angle is going down. It's a lot easier to learn how to hover with a low camera angle than it is trying to hover with a 45 degree camera angle. I'm going to put my camera angle at, let's just say, 3 degrees. I'm also going to toggle on my sticks so that you can watch the sticks as I'm trying to hover, keeping below the top of the flag and these three flags in line with each other. So, hover practice. I'm going to purposely move left and right so that you can see the flags are no longer in line with each other. And now let's get them back in line as much as possible. Let's get past our launch pad. And the idea is to hover with those three flags in line as much as possible, keeping your quadcopter as still as possible. And you're using very minute stick movements in order to do this. And you just keep practicing that. While you're in acro mode, this is not self-leveling mode, just keep practicing this until you get comfortable doing the hover. I'm gonna hit R to reset ourselves. I'm gonna increase our camera angle just a little bit, let's say 7 degrees. And now our next drill is slow forward flight and learn how to slow down. We're going to go to each flag and slow down. I'm going to get over here on the side and I'm going to pitch back to slow down and pitch forward to go forward and pitch back to slow down and pitch forward to go forward and pitch back to slow down. And we're going to reset ourselves. And our next drill is going to be coordinated turns in a square pattern, first to the left and to the right. And I'm going to increase our camera angle for that as well. Let's just say 25 degrees. And we'll go with that. Square pattern to the left. And you don't have to go fast. Just try and maintain your altitude below the tips of the flags. We're not in any hurry. We're just learning slow, coordinated turns to the left using both yaw and roll to the left in a square pattern. And then, as I mentioned earlier, we want to do this both directions so we don't gain one predominant side. Yaw and roll right. Yaw and roll right, same direction. Sticks and both sticks moving in the same direction. Yaw and roll right. Like that. I'm gonna reset. And our last drill for this particular video is coordinated turn using more yaw and roll, this time in a figure eight using two flags. And I'm gonna do that by increasing my camera angle to 45 degrees, and demonstrate this. Figure eights. Once again, we're not in any big hurry. We're just learning how to do yaw and roll figure eights around two obstacles. In this case, we just happen to stick two flags in the ground. And we could also extend that to maybe some sort of slalom with three flags. One of the things I wanted to point out is how realistic the flight physics are with Velocidrone. And by doing these sorts of practice drills over and over again, you're forming good muscle memory based on good flight physics.
So that in a nutshell is my take on the value of FPV simulators for learning FPV and a quick demo of how to use Velocidrone to both make your own track and for practice flight drills. Please keep in mind Velocidrone, DRL, and liftoff can be used for freestyle as well as racing through their large number of tracks available. If you found this video useful, make sure to share it with your friends and head on over to the TMacFPV.com site where you can find more free resources and the Fast Track FPV course, your clear flight path to FPV fun. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.